Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today I will try to explain the technology in your current day driving wheels for sim racing. There are three main means of transmission: gear driven, belt driven and direct drive. The principle of gear driven is simple. Connect your motor via a small cog to another cog that drives a steering wheel. Advantages of the system is that it is a sturdy mechanism because of the lack of flexible parts and that it delivers a constant velocity. The disadvantage is that for sensitive systems like racing a car, there is always a dead zone between where the cogs fit into each other. Belt-driven bases use a principle of a motor driving a belt, connecting a driving and a driven shaft that is connected to the steering wheel. As an advantage, the transition delivery is much smoother. The most important disadvantage of the system is that it has a flexible intermediate, bringing over the power that is more prone to braking and less constant velocity delivery due to the polygonal effect. A direct drive system is something simple. It's a motor that drives a steering wheel directly. It can deliver much more torque in a more direct way as it doesn't have any intermediate parts between the driver and the driven part. As a disadvantage, the motor needs to be relatively sensitive and deliver enough power. This servo motor also needs a much more complex driver, bringing the cost of manufacturing higher than the motors of the two above. The large difference between the gear and belt driven wheels and the direct drive wheel is that the first two have the ability to transform speed into power. If you want to know the technical details about it, you can look it up at Wikipedia. Basically, when a small wheel is connected to a bigger wheel, this will cause for the big wheel to turn slower than the first wheel, but it will make it much harder to stop the shaft connected to that bigger wheel. Due to the design for gear driven bases, the conversion rate is generally higher than belt driven. Adding torque to a belt driven system can be done by creating a hybrid or using dual belts to transfer power. One of those hybrids is the latest T248 of Thrustmaster. I bought this base recently to review it and opened it up to see what the hybrid was about. In this wheelbase, the driving motor is connected to a series of smaller and larger cogs to amplify the torque, after which it is being driven by the last cog to the shaft driving the steering wheel by means of a belt. This results in a combination of more torque and the fluidness of a belt system. Unfortunately, you do still feel so small pieces of dead zones in practice, but the amount of torque does improve drastically over both gear and belt driven bases. A system using the dual belt system is a Thrustmaster T300 series, which has one belt driving another belt driving the wheel. This will up the torque some and keep the transmission to the steering wheel smooth. So there are four different drive mechanisms in use at the moment. We have the gear driven with Logitech G29, G920 and G923. We have the belt gear hybrid driven, like the Thrustmaster T150 RS, TMX, the T248. We have belt driven, like Thrustmaster T300 RS, TXRW, T500 RS, TSPC, TGT, TGT2, TSXW and Fanatec CSL Elite, and Club Sport V2.5, and then we have the direct drive systems like the Fanatec Podium, DD1, DD2, GTDD Pro, and soon perhaps a Thrustmaster TDD. It seems that Fanatec's closing down on the belt-driven wheels and focusing more solely on the direct drive bases. This is probably because manufacturing prices for DD bases has come down for them due to the needed motors being more mass-produced. Mind you, this is speculation, but if you look at how sharp they priced their Fanatec GDDD Pro, not unlikely. Further, we know that Thrustmaster will be trying its first steps in the direct drive markets, which is exciting for us racing enthusiasts. There is no real news from Logitech, which is a shame since it is by far the largest manufacturer of the three. I hope I was able to explain some things to you. I just have seen this question pop up a few times already and wanted to explain. I'm not really a technical person, so if there are some errors in this video, do give the feedback so I can add it to the offered information. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already, as it really helps supporting me. Any feedback, being questions or added information about this topic is always welcome. I will see you all in next video.